Hi guys, thank you for joining me. Hope you're enjoying your day so far. USGS is reporting two earthquakes along the New Madrid earthquake zone, the largest being a 1.6 at 11:29 Universal Time. That would have been 6:29 a.m. today, Central Daylight Time, or 4:29 Pacific Standard Time, or 7:29 East Coast Time. This one was shallow, or about 4 miles below sea level, and all earthquakes are measured from sea level. The other one, a 1.5, which occurred earlier, which actually would have been yesterday, at 1:15 p.m. in the afternoon, Central Daylight Time. And neither of these earthquakes were reportedly, supposedly, felt or sent in reports to USGS. Here's the seismic signature of the 1.6. Let me make that bigger for you. There was other little ones. You can see it right there. Kind of hard to tell. But this is the earthquake. 1.60. And I'll show you the spectrogram. And then using Google Earth, zooming into the location of that earthquake. Here we go. Now, I don't know if you noticed, but we'll pull this out. This is an area off on the right. This is New Madrid. And this is the area where the fault line has actually been broken and faulted and twisted around. You can tell that by the river. This here, too, is the location of the 1811, 1812, 8.5 earthquake. That earthquake made the Mississippi River flow backwards and rang bells as far as Boston, Massachusetts. Aftershocks continued for years. People actually laid logs on the ground because of the crevices that were opening up, swallowing up people, so they could grab the logs and hopefully keep them from being sucked down into the earth. Davy Crockett even has a report of one of the fault zones that opened up that he chased a bear into. The 1.5. Now that was yesterday, like I said. 1:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. They got the 9th for Universal Time. Here's the location of the one earthquake monitor where I downloaded the data. BRNM. So again, going to Google Earth, we'll go to the location of that 1.5. Right there. Yeah, and you notice all the blowholes? Yeah. Now, blowholes are when water mixed with sand and it shoots up into the air during an earthquake. There's a lot of unreinforced masonry buildings in this location. I've talked about that in years past. Here's the 1.5, and here's the earthquake station, CACT. At the monitor, CACT, here's that earthquake right there at 18:15 Universal Time. And there's its spectrogram. It actually came in as a magnitude 1.67. And it shook for a while. Let's go to its signature. Yeah, I shortened up the signature, but yeah, it was at least that, 1.67. They have another one marked in red on this monitor. Actually, several of them that are not being reported. We got this one right here at 1916. On the left is BRNM. On the right is CACT. There's the earthquake. I don't know if you can see it right through there on the other monitor. There's the spectrogram. And this comes in as a magnitude 2.04, not being reported. I had to go back and download some more files because more recently there was this one marked in red. Yeah, I don't have the whole signature for some reason. Let me try something. All right, ended up closing the whole file. That still doesn't want to show. What is going on with that? Let's go to the spectrogram. Nope, I shut it down. I reloaded it. Yeah, it's as bad as them there at the University of Utah shutting down the monitors. Can't get the whole wave of the earthquake to see how large it probably was. Now, this is going to be greatly underestimated, but it comes in as a 1.29 for what I do have. Using the stream view, that's the location of that earthquake, but I would not be able to extract exactly how large it is. Yeah, it looks like there was another one afterwards. Maybe later today I can get the file to work. But you can see the computer picked it up and it's marked in red. And then we got another one marked in red right there at 1415. There's the spectrogram and it comes in as a 2.40. Yeah, they don't want you to know about this. Oh, it was your imagination that you felt this earthquake. And then there's another one marked in red. Let me see if I can find it. Right there. 1327. Lots of activity. See, above that. Yeah, 1327. Right there. That comes in as a magnitude 2.04. Well, look at its spectrogram. Yeah, things are really active today along the New Madrid fault zone. And then yesterday, you can see we got several marked in red. Now, this is the monitor that's up there where the 1811-1812 earthquake occurred. And we got several right there. And I'll pull it over for you. Yeah, the computer picked it up, but they decided they were not going to report them. Yeah, look at that. We got a screw wave. Now, I've talked about, let me show you, how this whole area is a failed rift system where the United States was originally going to separate and divide up in half. And there is an area, let me see if I can find it. All right, up over here. Here's where all these earthquakes have been occurring. Up over here, they actually have an ancient volcano. It's called Hicks Dome. And there's ancient lava flows in this location also. I got it circled in red, but you can actually see the direction of the lava flows and the center of the volcano. So when you see screw waves and the seismic signature of heated water and gases coming up, it does not surprise me in one bit. We also have some strange seismic signature. I haven't done enough research in this area to tell you if it's blobs of magma. It is harmonic tremors. And let's go to the spectrogram. Let me come down here. But I haven't done enough research to know if, in fact, this is showing the indication along the rift system of heated water or magma or anything like that. See, it doesn't want to show there. All right, right there. Where you have rift zones, example, the Ring of Fire, yeah, you're going to have magma intrusion, lava intrusion. So I'm going to this other monitor and just kind of looking around here at this stuff. So let me go up here. Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. Like I said, it's a failed rift system. Wouldn't surprise me at all if that's what the signature is picking up. Yeah, and then down here, let me look at this. So anyways, if you guys thought you felt some earthquakes today that are not being reported by USGS, well, you did. And if you did, please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Make sure you're still subscribed. Yeah, Big Brother YouTube keeps unsubscribing people and not sending out notifications because of their censoring. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.